Since Beyond comes with a pre-built mapping for the APC-40, it has become the most common controller for laser operators to use. Additionally, Pangolin sells a skin for the controller that labels every knob, button, and slider. The console comes with many different segments. The slider segment is used for live effect control. These sliders adjust master brightness, four banks of effects, XY size, visible points, scan rate, and animation speed. The horizontal slider is mapped to control the first row of quick effects, which is typically colors. You can cycle through the color effects with the slider, and with your FX1 slider up, you can see we're adjusting the color of the cues. If you would like to fade in the color, select the color and fade in your FX1 slider. You also have control of your second, third, and fourth effect bank. All you have to do is select the effect you want. This will be brightness effect. Make sure your animation speed is up, and your second effect bank slider is up. If you want to get rid of this effect, simply slide down the effect 2 slider or press the button again. Next, we have cue control. This grid of buttons controls every single cue. Simply tap the cue that you want to play and hop between them quicker than it would be clicking with the mouse or using a keyboard. There's also buttons for muting, unmuting, and selecting zones on the bottom, as well as additional buttons for live control on the right. Over here, you have your knobs. These can be used for rotation on the X, Y, and Z axis, either master rotation or animated rotation. To reset the rotation, simply press the button Reset Rotation. You also have control on the size of your Y and X axis, color control, position on the X, Y, and Z axis, as well as a transition speed knob. Over here, you have buttons that allow you to hop between pages and categories on your workspace, as well as a button to tap the tempo. If you're listening to a song and you want the animation to go to the beat, simply play the animation and tap the tempo of the music to set the speed of the cue. If the tempo changes, press Resync and change the speed of your tapping. You can also toggle the virtual laser jockey button, as well as resetting your effects banks and other resets. Finally, you have your enable and disable laser output buttons, as well as your master blackout button.